No one wants to be a victim of crime. Yet, unfortunately, thousands of these events occur all over the planet, every day, and it doesn't discriminate. Sometimes, incidents of crime are unavoidable. However, there are courses of action you can take, which will lower your chances of becoming a victim. And today, we are going to look at 19 ways to prevent this happening to you. Number 19. Break routine as much as possible. Suspecting criminals watch for routine in a potential victim's lifestyle. The more information they have about the victim, the better. Try to not arrive at home or leave for work at exactly the same time every day. Put some variation into your schedule, such as taking a different route to your home or work. When leaving your home, tell someone where you're going and estimate a time of arrival. That way, if something happens to you, police know exactly where to look for you. Number 18. Body language. A criminal will look to size you up in a matter of seconds to see if you would make an easy victim. Their two biggest fears are getting hurt and getting caught. Criminals assess basic movements while walking, like stride length, speed, body weight distribution, and arm swing, for signs of vulnerability. Movements and actions could signal unease and uncertainty. However, you can take steps to protect yourself by changing your behavior, including modifying your walking patterns to project yourself as someone who would be difficult to subdue and who would likely cause a scene. In other words, a hard target. While you may not be able to consistently control the nonverbal signals you give off, the knowledge of what the criminal is looking for gives you an enormous advantage. You can try to incorporate that knowledge into your daily movements and influence how you are perceived. Take forceful, confident steps with a gait that is neither too short nor too long. Walk tall. Shoulders back, chin up, arms. Let them bend naturally at the elbow and swing them as you walk. Awareness. Take a look around as you walk, noticing people and things that might seem out of place. Give people a split-second glance, showing them that you know they are there. Relax. Stay calm, cool, and collected. Number 17. Cell phone and headphones. If you must be out walking with headphones in your ears, be it listening to music or having a conversation, take one of the buds out of your ears so you are able to maintain some awareness around you. So many times, people have been hit from behind, had their purse, bag, wallet stolen because they can't hear anything that's going on around them. Criminals are looking for easy victims. By not being aware of your environment, you become a more likely target. Many think talking on a cell phone deters criminals because you can summon help, but it actually signals you're distracted. When your phone pings, signaling that you have a new text, it is very easy to lose track of your surroundings. The moment your chin drops and your awareness focuses on your screen, you turn into a potential mark. Number 16. Cars and public transport. When approaching your car, carry your keys in your hand. Digging for keys at your car door is a distraction. Be sure to check the passenger seats before you get in. Once you have gotten in, lock all your doors straight away. Some cars automatically lock, but only once you have started to drive. This doesn't help you because when you have just gotten in your car is when criminals are most likely to strike in order to carjack, rob, assault, rape, or kidnap you. Be wary about flyers on your windshield. Criminals will sometimes put one there, hoping you'll get out of your car to read it. Put your purse, bags, and other valuables, even garage door openers, out of sight even while driving. Have windows up or down only slightly. Not enough of a gap for someone to stick their hand in there. In parking structures, go toward the light. park where there is traffic. Well-lit CCTV cameras, not in the back where it's quiet and dark. If you think you're being followed, drive to a police station or a well-lit gas station. Never try to evade another car by driving down isolated streets. Don't use trains or trams at night, specifically after 9 p.m., in particular on Friday and Saturday nights. Catch a taxi or Uber instead at these times. There is no price on your safety. If you have no choice and must use a train or tram, make sure if you witness antisocial behavior or you are suspicious of someone to immediately move to another carriage if possible or exit at the next stop. You can catch the following one. It's not worth becoming a victim to be on time. If someone follows you, once you're off the train or tram, go to the front carriage and alert the driver. If the train or tram has departed, stick to well-lit areas with a lot of traffic. If that is not an option, scream and yell. Draw attention to yourself. Use your phone, put it on speaker, and call 911 or the number for emergency services in your country, making sure to let the stalker know who you're calling. Number 15. Don't show wealth. Don't flash money, even when inside a business establishment. Some robbers hang out in stores in order to spot victims carrying a lot of cash. Robbers target people who flaunt material possessions or display a cocky, condescending attitude. Never put your wallet in a back pocket. Fine clothes, flashy jewelry, and expensive cars attract attention. Also, be sure to park in an attended garage. If you're visiting entertainment districts, particularly those near high crime areas, dress down if possible. If you have to withdraw money on the street, never do it at night, and make sure you put it in your bag or pocket straight away while facing the machine. Not when you have turned around, where it is exposed and other people can see. Number 14. Bars and clubs. Don't drink to excess. As drunken people appear more vulnerable, place themselves in dangerous situations more often, and give off signals. Predators may misinterpret as sexual interest. Never leave your drink unattended. Use of such mickeys as date rape drugs is on the rise. If someone sends over a drink, don't drink it. You want to see who poured it. Never leave alone. Ask bar or club security to walk you to your car.